Hey guys, it's Lacey. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing a favorite slash stuff I've tried in May and June. I was actually gonna film an empties video, but somehow half of my empties bag got emptied into like the real trash. Yeah, I've got a lot to talk about, so I'm just gonna jump into it because my air conditioning's off and it's 95 degrees outside in Chicago, which is essentially like 300 degrees. So the first thing I'm gonna talk about is Differin. I did the whole 3 month trying it out, retinization, and as of like the past year, I've been getting like breakouts on my cheeks and I have no idea why. And I thought this would help and it didn't. So I don't know. I'm not discouraging people from trying it necessarily because there's people who swear by Differin. I did see a improvement in my overall skin. Like I felt like my forehead lines looked a little less noticeable, which was nice. But other than that, it's just like, I'm not repurchasing this. I'm not finishing it. I think it's pretty harsh on my skin. A lot of moisturizers that I love and are really gentle still kind of burn me when I use this. So that's kind of not great. One of them being CeraVe PM. This is my second bottle and I absolutely love this. I don't think I'm gonna repurchase it though. I'll get into why in a bit. Yeah, this is one of the ones that kind of burned me when my skin was like at its most sensitive, but other than that, I think it's really gentle. This has niacinamide and hyaluronic acid. I think I said both of those right. Use it during the day and at night, it's just run out of it like crazy. So that kind of sucks. Another empty is the Glossier Milky Jelly Cleanser. I really like this. I don't think it's an amazing makeup remover. I'll just say that up front. You use the toner and you'll see the truth. It smells like rose. It feels really nice on your skin. It's jelly. It's cool. It's very refreshing. And this was my second time purchasing this. I haven't repurchased it again because I have some other cleansers I want to use up before, but I can definitely see myself repurchasing this. It's a good standard go-to, gentle, really refreshing and cooling. That's what I like. I do have one tip though. If you're in the shower and trying to take off your makeup, this is not going to work. If you put this on a dry face and then work it in, that helps get off your makeup so much more than just lathering your face while it's already wet. Just a tip. Next up, I have Dr. Brand Base Lumiere Luminizing Primer Pores No More. I think this does absolutely nothing for my pores. Pores are still there, but I do think this is a really beautiful product. This is really good if you're really into like the no makeup look. I love wearing this on days I'm not wearing foundation or I'm just wearing concealer. It's just really, like it says, luminizing. I just wear it like on the tops of my cheeks. I know this like doesn't look amazing, but it just can give you like an overall really pretty glow. Do you see how like the light is just like reflecting? I don't know, it looks better on the face. I'm into it. My toe just made like a really weird noise. Next up is something that's pretty new to me, but I've been using it for the last almost 2 weeks. It's a Pixi Glow Tonic. I know people rave about this, and I thought this wasn't gonna work. I mean, I've been wanting to try it, but this is $17 just for this little bottle. I bought actually the $3 trial that they sell at Target, and I was like, wait, this is like really giving me a glow the next day, and I used up that sample and bought a new one in 2 weeks flat. Like, I used this morning and night, and I thought my skin was not gonna be like into this. I thought my skin was gonna be like, hey, we're sensitive, we can't do this. But it actually is getting along really well. On days where I feel like my skin's a little dry, I might just use like my Witch Hazel Bayer's toner, and that's amazing. But this like gives you a real glow. Like I feel like I'm really just like getting my skin life together when I use this. And honestly, I think it's totally worth the money. Next up is the Mario Badescu Facial Spray with Aloe, Chamomile, and Lavender. I actually filmed a video doing like first impressions of a bunch of products that I'm actually gonna mention here again because that video, the lighting was super weird. I knocked the camera, so I was like half in the video, half not. And so obviously didn't upload that one. But I tried this out in the video. It smells kind of like ginger more than it does chamomile and lavender, but this shit is good. And if you like rose, I think you'll like this one too. Next up is CeraVe. My mom actually gave me this. I've kind of been a diehard Aveeno, like the green body lotion one, girl for a while. I don't know why, because that one's kind of sticky. Like it doesn't really absorb into the skin. This one really does. Like, does it even say that it's fast absorbing? just as lightweight. It's doing anything for my eczema, I'll say that for sure. It's non-comedogenic, so you can use it on your face, which I'm all about. Like body lotions, I can just put on everywhere, one product into that. Because some days I like an oil, some days I like something that's like more water-based. And yeah, I'm into this. Next up is the Amika Keep Your Color Conditioner. I actually thought this was shampoo because I was out of shampoo. And I really like this conditioner. I feel like it actually really conditions my hair. The smell lingers, which I love. But this packaging is god awful. Like, would I repurchase? Probably. Do they need to work on their packaging? Maybe that's why it's at Marshall's. But like, it is the stiffest. Like, it is. Like, even when you open this up, it's a workout. I honestly do this and just like I can't do the squeezing. It hurts. Next up is the Macadamia Natural Deep Repair Mask. The smell of this stuff is amazing. I feel like it actually does really moisturize. It does feel like a mask. This is like as much as I can ask for when I get like a hair mask. Like, I want it to actually work to the point where if I accidentally don't wash my hair out enough, that like I can tell, I'm like, whoa, too much moisture, too heavy. Like, that's what I want. I have thick, wavy, kind of curly, crazy hair that loves to tangle and be frizzy and just like, oh, it's, there's a, like, I need help. This helps. Last up in here is this wet brush. So wet brush actually came out with a brush that's a paddle brush that has some bristles, which I love. I love this. I love this. I love this. I have hair that I have to wash absolutely every day or it gets greasy. Like, I don't know how people can go days and like dry shampoo. And I use dry shampoo too, but I wanted something to distribute those oils so I can go a couple days without washing my hair because my ends are getting so dry. And I've been a diehard of the wet brush regular one. I use this, I have it in two different colors, like a travel one and one I keep at home. Like, I can't live without these brushes. And the fact that they came out with a bristle one and it still has like these, the regular bristles, like these, like I could not have asked for more in a brush. The thing that's like not makeup or skincare related is the Brazilian Bum Bum Cream. Oh my god, this smells so good, and it's so expensive. I'm definitely not buying a full size, but I got a trial size in the Beauty Fix. So good, but it's really, really shimmery, so I don't know how I feel about that. It doesn't like break out my skin in terms of like eczema or irritation, like most fragrance and sparkly things do. Very moisturizing and not sticky, and it's perfect, and it's like a ridiculous price for the full size, and I don't know if I can justify it. I'm gonna see how long I can live without it and let you know. So I'm totally jumping around, sorry, like I've mixed makeup and skincare and everything. Anyways, what you can see that I'm holding right now is the True Blue collection by Herbivore. Oh my god, guys, this stuff is so good. Let me calm down. It's a skin clarifying duo for combination oily, blemish-prone skin. I'm definitely combination skin and a bit like I have acne. It comes with the Blue Tansy mask and a little lapis oil. The mask size is really good. I'm still working through that. And the oil, I finished and I bought the full size, which it's $72. It's so good, guys. It actually does something to my skin. I'm not like a big oil person. I actually thought my skin hates oils. But my skin really likes it. Like, whatever mood my skin is in, it likes this oil. And my skin can be very temperamental. This is gonna sound crazy, but the mask is the real star of the show. I actually think this mask does more for my skin and acne than different did for the whole 3 months that I used it. Like, if my skin's breaking out, I can still use this mask and it won't burn my skin or anything, even though it is a chemical exfoliator. It has alpha and beta hydroxy acids in it. I love the way it makes my skin look afterwards. My boyfriend has used it multiple times, like we'll do them together, it's really cute, and our skin feels great the next day. Like, I highly, highly recommend this mask, and this duo is only $29, so it's a really good way to test out products that are quite expensive on their own and making sure that you actually really like it before you buy it. Like, the mask is $45, the oil is $72, and I'm definitely repurchasing these probably till the end of time. Okay, one random little thing. It's these Bando bags I got off Amazon. Everything will be linked below. It is amazing to have these kind of little purse separators. I just keep like lipsticks, whatever else I need, birth control, probiotics, things I need on the daily, and then some pens, because I love to draw, so I like to have like a couple microns on me and a marker, a white pen and a hair tie. So these are amazing. I keep them in my work bag, and then when I'm out on the weekends, I can just throw it into my little mini backpack. It's just good to have all of your essentials like in a little thing that you can just transfer from one bag to one bag to one bag, so you're not constantly forgetting things like I used to. So on to makeup. The QAF palette from ColourPop I've been using like crazy this month. Is that in focus? I have no idea. I'm gonna get up and just like show you the mess it is though. Like, I can't even begin to like try to clean these off because they just end up smudging everywhere and staining the actual packaging, which really sucks. I really like this palette. I'm only wearing this on my eyes today. Wearing just these two colors, I think, with a pop of this, and I really like it. I think the yellow could be way more pigmented. This is definitely the color I struggle the most with, but the rest of these are, like, even this and this, so good. This was $14. Maybe that's why I think it's amazing. Like, these aren't gonna be like Anastasia eyeshadows. If you need an affordable warm tone palette, like, this is where it's at. Next, I have some Sonia Kashuk brushes. I had really high hopes for these Sonia Kashuk brushes. They were some of the first brushes I had ever tried, period, when I got into makeup. I would buy them from Target. I still have like one eyeshadow brush that I use all the time. It's actually my sister, she gave it to me. It's from like her Coral collection. It's like a silver coral handle. That's like years and years old, and it's so good. There's a lot of brushes that I've had from Sonia Kashuk that are so good and really old. So these, the handles are freaking beautiful. I used these in that tutorial that like didn't work out. I'm sorry, this is like the one with like a little gold butt. It says that it's a flat top concealer. I think it's more for like pigmentation issues, scarring, acne versus underneath your eye, because this just won't do it. It just won't. It will never blend. This I thought would blend. Thought this would be really good for NARS Soft Matte that would actually pick up the product from the pot and actually distribute it well. It does distribute it, but there's just no blending with this. It just moves it around, never blends it out. And I'm just really disappointed with these, and I'm really sad because they weren't cheap. I think this on its own was like $18 or $16. The contour brush and the blush brush are definitely workable. They might have come individually and this came with a set. But I would recommend these. I think they work great. I use both of these for my blush and bronzer today, and they actually pick up product well. So I do recommend these. So if you can find the blush by itself, I'd recommend it, but I wouldn't buy the whole set with the fan brush. It's just not worth it. Just a couple more things. Also, Big Shot by Maybelline. It's Maybelline X Shayla, and I love makeup by Shayla, but this just doesn't work out for me. This gives me spider lashes, transfer on the bottom. I love Lash Paradise. I'm gonna be sticking to that. I'm very picky when it comes to mascara. This just doesn't do it for me. No shade to Shayla whatsoever. For me, I need a lot of lift. I need a lot of length and separation. I'm prone to little triangles that happen. My eyelashes are very straight. They don't like to be curled. I actually use a curling iron to heat up my eyelash curler sometimes, and then I tap it on the back of my hand, make sure it's not too hot, and I'll curl my eyelashes, and that's like the only thing that will keep them curled. Like, right? Yeah, I feel like mascara is just very personal, and it just didn't work out for me. Next, I have two eyebrow gels, one that I liked and one that I didn't. And the one that I liked is L'Oreal Brow Stylus. It's pretty small, which I like. It has some fibers in there that I think are really effective. It's pretty pigmented. I can definitely use this just alone and have like a decent brow day when I'm feeling extra lazy. I'm definitely gonna repurchase this. Next one I have is the Essence Lash and Brow Gel. I hate clear packaging. Like, it's disgusting. Just like, didn't make my eyebrows stay in place whatsoever. So this was a hard pass. It's like 99 cents, but honestly, I don't even think it's worth the 99 cents. No, I'd rather buy gum. Okay, two more products. This is the Replenix Plumping Lip Treatment. I love this. I got this in my Beauty Fix box from Dorm Store, and it has SPF, I think, 15? 30. It's truly like the perfect gloss. I know I talked about Fenty Gloss Bomb. I haven't even been using that lately. As much as I love it, one, I can't find it. Two, this is just so clear and glossy gloss, and it's not sticky, and it's super moisturizing, and it has SPF 30, so it's just, I have the tiniest sample. I'm gonna buy the full size, which is $35, and I think that's worth it because it has SPF in it, and it's actually moisturizing, so it feels like a bit of skincare. I'm just casually holding the next and last item. This is the Smashbox Primer Water. I don't know why I haven't picked this up sooner. I've been using MAC Studio Fix Fluid in, I think, NC42, and I really love the color of that foundation. I'm not wearing that one on my face right now. I'm wearing Maybelline Fit Me. Don't like the formula of MAC Studio Fix Fluid. It's just too drying. I get like weird dry skin around this area. This is the only thing that saves it. If I prime my skin with this, just spray a shit ton on my face beforehand and then use it, it looks great all day, and then I'll spray it after. Like, it's incredible. It's like a whole new foundation. Like, if you have any foundations that you want to use up because for some reason you can't return it, or it's the only shade that really works for you, because that's kind of my thing, is like there's not that many foundations that work with my weird skin tone. Like, I'm tan but not, and I'm definitely not red. I'm pretty yellow, and it's hard to find. So this is one of my favorite products of the entire month. That was a lot. Thanks for sitting through that. Sorry I haven't uploaded in a minute. I've tried, but I've had issues. Hope to be uploading more. Let me know what you guys want to see next. I think I'm gonna do an Amazon favorites. I was thinking about doing that today, but instead I just rounded up like everything. Like, you know what? Let's just talk about everything. Let me know if you have any recommendations of things I should try, videos you want to see, let me know. I'm gonna sit in front of the AC for about 20 minutes and go get my nails done, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye! Naya? Niacinamide? I'm gonna sneeze. I'm not gonna blend, so.